needs to just get up there and keep his arm going fluent. Down the line, he's got a very strong throw, this Max. He just needs to keep control of it. But as we said, out of the eight players, Dave Richardson has got the best chance of going through to the quarterfinals tomorrow. Played well all day yesterday. Just got pipped by Bruyere, and it was on the doubles. Richardson missed him, and Bruyere didn't.
Yeah, both guys went into that final hitting more than half their darts at double. Bruyere just continued that. Richardson couldn't manage to do so, and that's what cost him. 99. Would have been a return to the World Championship, having played there a couple of years back. Went out in round one to the hammer, Andy Hamilton. Max Hopp is a man no stranger to Ali Pali. Turned up as a 16-year-old.
Yeah, there's no question that Max has got the talent, but he's just, the last year, 18 months, he's not moved forward enough for me. He just needs to keep control. You can see that, you know, he's got big long arms and he's really powerful, but that will certainly help his confidence. And sometimes he just tries to put too much power into that dart, and it just loses control at times. It's all about keeping that arm relaxed. Don't let the tension go from your head into your arm.
Well, you can't underestimate the pressure on young Max. 20 years old, the top player in Germany, a country that has fallen in love with this game. It is growing and growing and growing in Germany. And he is their big hope. Double 18 for a 1-2-1. What a start from Richardson. Davey boy into the lead.
A very tidy 15 dart opening leg for Dave Richardson, and it sent out a little message. Hopp now, he's got to hold on to his throat. Richardson's very experienced here in America. He's won a lot of tournaments. You don't want to let someone like this guy get in front of you too much.
He's very gracious, but he was obviously crestfallen after that last leg defeat to Willie J yesterday. That ultimately it was one leg of darts for $5,000 and a place at the World Championship. That is how brutal a contest it turned out to be.
Yes, it was ironic. I mean, he hit 10 140s in his semi-final game, another handful in the final. The only 140s that Bruyere hit with a kick off the last leg.
What a man, 7-10-40 for the maximizer. Max carrying the hopes of German darts on his shoulders. You kind of think that if somebody could share that load with him, it might free him up. We've got Martin Schindler, his World Cup of Darts partner, who's learning the game and rising up the rankings. If he can share some of that load, potentially, that could see Max just relax and unlock some of that ability that we know he possesses and bring it on a more consistent basis. Has he gone the 14 route? He went the 14 route, didn't need to go that. Single 14 would have left the bullseye, and he's missed the double, hitting double 8 instead of double 11, and that makes this tricky.
Especially now. With Richardson putting some pressure on, now this double 6, especially for a guy that's about 6 foot 6. He's got to attack it with the first dart. Do not lay this low, and that is the worst thing that can happen because of that. He's covered most of that double 3 bed with the first dart. Now a chance here for Richardson to break the throw, and he's going to have two darts at double 10 to do so. Not a bad guide. Oh, and it's two now to the American.
We said that of all the elite players here in Vegas today, Max Hopp, on paper, looked the most vulnerable. Having gone 2-0 down, Max will be aware of that. Max knows that he's the wild card pick. But having gone 2-0 down.
100.
Well, he may But he's been there a lot of times, but not in this situation. This is a bigger situation. Like you said, because he's been the wild card pick, he's going to now have in his head, oh, blimey, I can't embarrass myself. I've got to do this, I've got to do that. And all of a sudden, you know, the 6 inches between his ears is the thing that could ruin him. Just needs to keep his mind free. Just keep his action nice and fluent.
Well, look, Max is a hugely impressive young man. If I'm as mature as Max was at 16, when I'm 40, I'll be a happy man. And if I speak as good English.
You're not 40 yet, then.
Why? One.
He needs to get a leg on the board. Well, he's going to get six darts from 186. However, he cannot afford to have a visit without a treble, because with Richardson on the 146, obviously a lot. Oh, this could be a good visit.
138. That will do very nicely for the maximizer. Oh, well, it just looks so inviting to nestle 90. Another one in the treble 20 there. But both men on 48. Hopp. Double 16. It has to go, Max. Game and it does go. Man. Vital. And you can see the relief on the German's face.
Yes, you can see the relief with Richardson sitting on 48 as well. He cannot afford game on to let his opponent off anymore. He's got the break back. And now what he needs to do is just, I'm going to throw a nice little 12 dart leg just to get the confidence. However, Dan, you know, that first dart was absolutely perfect. He's got to make more of that first dart. And that's where sometimes, because he's a powerful young man, he gets too strong on his throw. 25. And people think, oh, you'll throw the dart high. No, when you're strong on your throw and your grip's too tight, it'll pull it low. See, another perfect first dart.
Making use of this, though, 10:40, still searching for the first maximum. Max Hopp, but a good response, having gone 2-0 down. He is a guy who looks after himself and works out, Max Hopp. I know you're a big advocate of players doing that. As you know, you were a fine specimen of a man yourself, Rod, when you were winning match plays and top of the world rankings.
Well, I won tournaments because I was the fittest, not the best player on the day. And the way that, you know, everybody's travelling now and... you know, like tomorrow, three matches. If you make the final, there's no good walking off saying, oh, I lost because I was a bit tired. Well, no sympathy when you're on that stage.
Well, would he go for it? That's the question. We will never know.
Well, I think the bullseye is the best option. He may go treble 18, but the bullseye is the best option, because if he hits an 18, he's still got two dart combination. If he hits the ball or 25... 90. See, if he'd gone for the bullseye 25, hits a 25, he comes back with 65, which guarantees him two darts at a double if the first one goes in the right place. Sometimes you have to play the percentage. Wow. Now he gets one dart at a double, and you know, Richardson's put the pressure on.
He certainly has. Is Hopp up to it? Tops he wants. Needs to avoid that first dart. The flight may be in the way, but he can't find the red bit at the top of the board. Richardson, 96. He can see this off in two darts. He's going to need all three. Well, he went double-double. 60.
Max, you require 20. Well, no, double-10. It's a double most players like, but you don't want to split it with the first one. So if you're going to miss just on the outside... Well, he will have to move to the left. That'll open it up. It opens him up, opens it up from where he's... Now, I'd still stay to the left, Max. The right, you're only seeing a half inch of the top of that double ten.
Well, it would have been a wonder dart to squeeze it in that part of the bet from there. Very nearly got there, but this for 3-1. Davey Boy Richardson is halfway to a place in the quarterfinals.
Game on. Yeah, Max, I felt he should have stayed to the left. The left takes the flights out of the shot. I know it's harder for a right-handed person to move further left, but by moving right, he could only see the top of that double 10, and he can see the flights. And that's possibly a bad decision.
Well, Max Hopp, as Germany's number one, is their World Cup of Darts captain, and he has featured in the quarterfinals of that competition a couple of times. But when you're looking at singles tournaments rather than the pairs, and he did play some good stuff at the recent World Cup with Max, when you look at singles competitions, it's a long while since he made the quarterfinal of anything. But that is the first 180 for the maximizer. Talking more than a year since he made a ranking quarterfinal, Max. Now he has had a slump in form, and he has had a bit of an injury problem. He had to take a couple of weeks out while he had a problem with his back sorted out. Just winning one game on the big stage here in Vegas would be a huge confidence boost. And right now, he's got it all on to make that happen.
The 11 dart leg. Max, that's what we need to see a little bit more of. Max, you've got to take the game to Richardson. You cannot sit back and let this man get comfortable.
Now, that is an issue in Max Hopp's game, which, to my untrained eye, he's had a problem with for a while. If he misses that treble 20 just below and he's blocking the bed, he perseveres. He stays up there when he'd be better off moving down to treble 19 or move over to treble 18. He's doing himself out of points, and he does it on a consistent basis, Max Hopp.
There are a few people that do it. I mean, that's different because there's a lot of room to the left, and now he's switched straight away. Yeah, when that dart is blocking it, and the camera picks up more the barrel, but it's the flight that the player can see. And that's the thing that's going to deflect that dart. So, you know, you're only losing 3 points from the treble 20 to treble 19, so switch straight away.
Well, you'll see Peter Wright later on, the world number three UK Open champion. He's a guy who does it, and Max Hopp's done it just there. And managed to pick up a ton. Peter Wright is a man who will persevere on treble 20 when it looks like he's covered off the bed, but he's so good at it that it doesn't really matter.
James Wade is another one. 60. Yeah, Van Gerwen, Anderson, Tyler, they'll switch straight away.
And again, we see it there. And he's just piling into that first dart. 60. When yeah.
Should have switched, especially with the third. The second dart, because the first was so far on the right, he has still got plenty of room. But the third should have been down.
And ultimately it means that Richardson is down to a finished first in this thing. Albeit a big one, but it's not one he needs to use the bullseye for.
You can see that second dart. You can see in his face where he's putting a bit more tension into it. That's where he's just got to relax and keep the fluency in the throw.
60. Well, just a 60, but he stayed straight and it leaves him a two dart checker. Hopp, starting on the 19s. Now treble 20 for bull. It's the only way.
93. Well, he set it up perfectly. However, Richardson on 100, he'll go double top tops now. There's the first one, the exhibition shot, and it's Richardson.
Magnificent. The Canadian tops for a ton checkout. He is 4 out of 5 on his doubles. This is even better in terms of the finishing than we saw in the quarterfinals and the semi-finals yesterday, that took Richardson, without breaking a sweat, really, into the final of the North American Championship. He only dropped a couple of legs against Brenneman and Chris White. 91. Wow, that's quite the journey.
41.
Yeah, you were saying earlier on about Max, sometimes when you have a dip in form, perhaps there's another avenue that you should go down just to change things. I'm not saying drastically, but just the odd 1 or 2%. It may be, I don't know, in football you change the coaches, in golf you change your coach or your caddy. Sometimes you just have to go out of the norm just to, you know, take a different line of attack on it. And I think perhaps Max needs to just look at himself as Richardson hits his first maximum of the match, and he's really taken the game to Max Hopp now.
Richardson is now averaging in the mid-90s. He is hitting 80% of his darts at double. And Max Hopp, who was playing with a smile on his face earlier on, has had it wiped off by Davey Boy. Single 15.
65.
And that will do nicely for Richardson. He will come back with three darts in his hand, looking at tops for a 5-2 lead.
Well, Dan, we've commentated a lot of times. How many times have I said, you know, you nick a throw, then hold on to yours very strongly, and if he takes this out, be a 15-dart leg. I was going to say, that's exactly what he needed to do. However, he has given Max Hopp a little lifeline here.
It's on. Oh, my word. Well, I think it must have caught the flight. It looked to be heading, not in the 20 anyway.
But that dart
should have been... Oh, now he busted score.
It should have been at double top. The second dart should have been at double top. You have to take the treble out of the equation. Absolute mistake from Max Hopp, but not a mistake from Dave Richardson. He's 5-2 up.
Absolute madness from Max Hopp. Mad Max. He should have been nowhere near that treble 20. If he'd been as near that treble 20 with a few more darts earlier in this game, he wouldn't have found himself 4-2 down in the first place. But Max Hopp has to win four legs on the spin, or his World Series debut is coming to an end at the very first hurdle.
The thing is, Dan, when you look at Max Hopp's darts, they really do kick up. So from the point in the board to the height of the flight, it's only 4 or 5 inches. And so you have to overpitch when you're on a big 20, and you see so many people that will overpitch so much they go in the double top. That's fine. But he hit the flight, which was crazy, or moved to the left. So you've got the open bed on the big 20.
Well, ultimately, that mistake could cost Max Hopp this match. He's still in it. But he is clinging on by his fingernails. Davey Boy Richardson having suffered the heartbreak of that last leg defeat in the final, missing out on a return to Ali Pali at the World Championship yesterday. Willie J claiming that spot at the World. Could he be about to do something incredibly special? Double 14 for Hopbo for 5-3, misses outside, and it's the 1-3-8. I don't think anybody's hit a 1-3-8 more important than this one.
Well, Max Hopp's coming back. Now, we have a little situation here for Hopp, where the double 14, the right-handed player, sometimes you pitch it well outside, and then the second one goes inside. He's got to attack it. He's got to find it first dart. Well, now double 7 right down the bottom of the board. And that was a pressure double for Max Hopp.
It really was. Dave Richardson, he hit a single 10 there to leave 50. Now, I'm assuming he miscounted there, but there's a little part of me that wanted to see him return and try and hit bullseye for the match against one of the 8 elite players that have been selected for Vegas. He has the throw in this leg and the decider if it goes the distance. This is Richardson's match to lose now. And a 10-40 may well be good enough.
Well, after that opening salvo from Richardson, you think that Max has got to look at a 12 dart leg, and this will help. That's unlucky. That's hit the barrels and just deflected. But a 140 in the match. Keep the pressure on your opponent.
Well, we've seen Max Hopp produce back-to-back legs of 12 and 11 darts. We've seen him throw a 9 darter, did it in a Euro Tour qualifier. And that is a second maximum for the maximizer. very best in the world, when their back is to the wall, they can find an extra gear. They can produce their best stuff. That is what Max Hopp has to do here. There is zero margin for error for the German.
Well, that 41 has opened the door up for Richardson. Ton plus here gives him the advantage. This will, he'll come down now. And do you know what? That is the biggest result that Max Hopp could have hoped for. Now, Richardson may only come back to one dart at a double instead of two. If Max Hopp, well, he's not going to take out the 140. Perhaps that seven has been a lifeline to Max Hopp.
Two match darts. And he only needs the one. Davey Boy Richardson, the man from Canada, 60% on the doubles and dumps out Germany's number one. We said this was a day for the North Americans to stand up and be counted and to deliver. And Davey Boy has done just that. Max Hopp knocks out 6-3 and Richardson through to the quarterfinals. It could be the world number one he faces.